the audio will travel also in this red line and it will go back to the laptop. This is now what we call audio loop. And this is one of the nightmares of the audio man out there. We should avoid this problem. Right now, I'm going to share with you how to set up a phone patch connection. But I'm going to divide it into two parts. First, phone patch connection with audio mixer. And the second part is phone patch connection without audio mixer. Okay? To begin with, I guess all of us have a cell phone. It doesn't matter if it is Android or iPhone. And we also use headset to speak if we call someone and to listen music in it. And I'm going to delve deeper with our 3.5mm headphone jack. We have several kinds of cell phone jack, but I'm just going to explain the two most common headphone jack. First, the CTIA, and the second is OMTP. Okay? As you can see, the configuration of the headphone jack, the left and the right will be the speaker, and there is ground and microphone. CTIA and OMTP is almost the same, only that the location of the ground and mic differs. But CTIA was used widely in the market by Android and iPhone. So I guess we're going to focus on CTIA configuration. But then if your headset is OMTP, then use OMTP configuration, okay? But for now, I'm going to focus on CTIA because this is the configuration of my headphone. Next, we're going to find an AV cable that will match with our headset configuration, which is CTIA. To do that, we're going to use the multimeter to check the configuration of our AV cable. I used the ohmmeter on the multimeter for you to see the deflection, if there is a connection or not, okay? The AV cable configuration should be the same with our headphone configuration in order for it to work. Otherwise, it will not work. After checking the AV cable, we identify that the left is white RCA. The right is the yellow RCA. So these are all for the speaker, okay? And the ground, it is next to the yellow, and the microphone is the red RCA. And so, the headphone that was used in our cell phone will be replaced with the AV cable. Okay, the mic will be the red RCA, and the headphone speakers will be the RCA white and yellow. Okay, since we already identify our AV cable configuration and it matched with our headphones. So, let us go now for the first part of this tutorial, which is the phone patch connection with the audio mixer. Okay? The materials we're going to use will be laptop, audio mixer, and cell phone. We also have audio cables and AV cable. This will be our diagram for the phone patch connection with audio mixer. The laptop is connected to the audio mixer using audio cables, while the cell phone is connected to the mixer using AV cable. Okay? I am sure that we do have different audio mixer. But for now, let us just focus on my audio mixer. And I guess the functions of the buttons of most audio mixers are identical. And I do hope all of us knows at least the basic of audio mixer. So now, let us use channel 9 and 10 as audio input from our laptop and channel 11, 12 as our audio input from our cell phone. Okay? To make things easy, let us connect first our laptop into our audio mixer. Ah, by the way, I'm using USB audio adapter to separate the mic and the speaker on my laptop. As you can see in the figure, the microphone of the USB audio adapter is connected to the output of the audio mixer. and the speaker of the USB audio adapter is connected to the channel 9 and 10 of the audio mixer. So, this is the connection of the laptop and audio mixer, and be sure to connect it right. Otherwise, there will be a problem later on your phone patch connection. Okay? Let's move on to our cell phone connection. The RCA yellow and white of the AV cable will be connected to the channel 11 and 12 of the audio mixer. And the red RCA of the AV cable will be connected to the audio output of the audio mixer that is coming from group 1 and 2. Okay? Just please remember that the yellow and white of the AV cable is the speaker of our cell phone. And the red RCA of our AV cable is the mic of our cell phone. And so, this will be the cable connections of our phone patch connection using the audio mixer. Okay, let us first summarize the connection. Let's begin with the laptop. The audio out of the laptop will be connected in the channel 9 and 10 of the audio mixer. So, whatever audio that is coming out from the laptop will be sent to the channel 9 and 10 in the audio mixer. And this audio out from the mixer will be the input audio to our laptop. And the sliding switch button of this audio output is this stereo out. So now, let's go to the connection of the cell phone, okay? Whatever audio that is coming out from our cell phone will be sent to the channel 11 and 12 via this RCA yellow and white of our AV cable. And whatever audio that is coming out from our mixer will be sent to our cell phone via this red RCA of our AV cable. The sliding switch button of this audio out is the group 1 and 2 of our audio mixer. And finally, I need your attention and please listen very carefully. This is the most crucial thing in phone patch connection. This will be the source of audio loop, audio feedback, or whatever audio problem in your phone patch connection. So that is why please listen, okay? I'm going to highlight this channel 9 and 10 and channel 11 and 12. Please remember, the channel 9 and 10 was connected on the laptop and the channel 11 and 12 was connected on the cell phone, okay? Just remember that. Now, do you notice this small push button, 1 and 2 and ST? This will play the very important role in our phone patch connection, and this will be the sources or the cause of audio loop, audio feedback, or whatever audio problem in our phone patch connection, okay? So, in the channel 9 and 10, which is connected on the laptop, the gray button 1 and 2 will be pushed on. And the red button ST will be pushed off. Okay? And in channel 11 and 12, the gray button 1 and 2 will be pushed off. While the red button ST will be pushed on. Okay? I hope you can follow the step-by-step connection on this diagram. Otherwise, there will be a problem later on.
For us to better understand the phone patch connection, I just made a simple circuit to show how the audio will travel from the laptop going to the cell phone and from the cell phone going to the laptop, okay? So let's go and we take a look.
So this is our simple circuit diagram. In the laptop side, we have the channel 9 and 10. This switch will be the sliding switch button. And the push button 1 and 2 and the red button ST, okay? And the audio input jack that is coming from the laptop. And same also with the channel 11 and 12, we have the switch, which is this one, the sliding switch button, and the push button 1 and 2 and the red button ST. And this is also the audio input jack that is connected to our cell phone speaker, okay? And these are the audio outputs from the mixer. The sliding switch button of group 1 and 2 will be the main switch of push button 1 and 2 of channel 9 and 10 and 11 and 12. And the sliding switch button stereo out will be the final switch of push button ST of channel 9 and 10 and 11 and 12. Okay? And this is the audio out of group 1 and 2, and it is directly connected to the mic of our cell phone. And lastly, this is the audio out that is coming from the sliding switch button of stereo out, and it is directly connected to the audio in of our laptop. Okay? Let us first consider our cell phone connection. As you can see, the 1 and 2 is off and SD is on. And assuming the remote caller will say hello.
Hello.
Let us trace now the path of the audio in our circuit. Okay? The phone patched cell phone will receive the audio hello and it will travel throughout the circuit. As you can see, this green line, and it will go to our laptop. And this is a good circuit. Okay? What if we're going to push on the 1 and 2? What will happen to the circuit? Now, both 1 and 2 and ST is on. So again, the remote caller will say hello.
Hello.
Our phone patch cell phone will receive the audio hello from our remote caller. So again, the audio will travel in the green line, okay? And it will go to the laptop. But then, the button 1 and 2 is on also. The audio will travel also in this red line. The audio hello will be sent to the microphone of our cell phone. And it will send the hello audio to our remote caller. So, this is the situation wherein the remote caller will hear his own voice after a few seconds.
Hello.
And this is very irritating to him. This is one of the audio problems that we should avoid, okay? So, you should push off the 1 and 2. Now, let's move to our laptop. Assuming we have a Zoom conference in our laptop, let us push on 1 and 2 and the ST is off, okay? Whatever audio that is coming from our laptop will travel with this green line and it will go to the mic of our cell phone. And this audio will be sent to the remote caller. And this is a good circuit. Okay? What if we're going to push on the ST button? What will happen to the circuit? So again, whatever audio that is coming from our laptop will travel in the green line and it will go through the microphone of our cell phone and that audio will be sent to our remote caller. But then, the push button ST is also on. So, the audio will travel also in this red line and it will go back to the laptop. This is now what we call audio loop. And this is one of the nightmares of the audio man out there. We should avoid this problem. So, the push button ST should be off, okay? Remember this figure? This should be followed for us to avoid some audio problems. Or you can play these buttons as long as you know what you are doing to avoid some problems, okay?
I hope you follow and understand our discussion of phone patch connection. And please do not memorize the circuit diagram of the phone patch connection. Instead, you understand it. Understand the concept. Because for sure, we do have different audio mixer, different application, or even different devices. And that means we have different circuit diagram or different connection. So that is why I want you to know or to understand the concept of how to make a circuit diagram of phone patch connection. So now, let's move on to the second part of our tutorial, that is phone patch connection without audio mixer. Okay? So, let's go on!
We just finished our discussion on the first part, which is phone patch with audio mixer. But on this second part, we're going to remove the audio mixer in the diagram, okay? And we are going to replace the audio mixer with RCA connectors. The white and yellow RCA of the AV cable will be connected to the audio in of the laptop. And the red RCA of the AV cable
will be connected to the audio out of the laptop. And again, I use this USB audio adapter on my laptop to separate the speaker and the microphone. And the microphone of the USB audio adapter will be connected to the audio in cable. And the speaker of this USB adapter will be connected to the audio out of the audio cable. And the same on the first part, the white and yellow RCA of the AV cable will be the speaker of our cell phone. And the red RCA of the AV cable will be the mic of our cell phone. Okay? So, this is the interface or the connection of the phone patch diagram without audio mixer. And now, let's move on and magnify the laptop. Assuming we're using Zoom conference on this tutorial, the audio of the Zoom conference we're going to feed in the cell phone in order for the remote caller to hear whatever audio that is coming from the Zoom conference. And the remote caller will speak to the Zoom conference via this phone patch connection. Okay? There are so many conference platforms, but I'm just going to use the Zoom conference as our example. Anyway, the audio interface connection is just the same in most of the platform. Okay? Let us focus to the microphone of our Zoom conference. Click this arrow up icon, and for the microphone, choose USB audio device because we are using USB audio adapter. And same to the speaker, choose also the USB audio device. Okay? In this connection, you cannot hear the audio of your laptop because we route it into the USB audio adapter. So you need an audio splitter as shown in the picture so that you can connect your speaker and you can connect also the microphone that will be connected to your cell phone. Okay, so that's it.
So this is how to set up a phone patch connection with and without audio mixer. If you have some question, some clarification, please don't hesitate to drop a comment below. And for those new to my channel, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you very much. Share the love.